Lovely.
This trick again? I know what you are. It won't work. I will stay strong. Only too well. Ugh, how far they must have delved into my thoughts.
The boy is exhausted. And this cage, I've never seen anything like it. Rest easy. Help is here. Ugh,
enough visions. If anything in you is human, kill me now and stop this game.
He's delirious. He's been tortured and has probably been denied food and water. I can tell. Here, I have a skin of...
Don't touch me! Stay away! Sifting through my thoughts, tempting me with the one thing I always wanted but could never have. Using my shame against me, my ill-advised infatuation with her. Oof. A mage, of all things. I am so tired of these cruel jokes, these tricks, these... Silence! I'll not listen to anything you say. Now be gone! Still here. But that's always worked before. I close my eyes, but you are still here when I open them. Don't blame me for being cautious. The voices, the images, so real. Why have you returned to the tower? How did you survive? Good. Kill Uldred. Kill them all for what they've done. They caged us like animals. Looked for ways to break us. I'm the only one left.
Be proud. You mastered yourself.
Be proud? What is there to be proud of? That I lived and they died?
They turned some into monsters and... there was nothing I could do.
What others? What are you talking about?
Irving and the other mages who fought Uldred. Where are they?
They are in the harrowing chamber. The sounds coming up from there. Oh, Maker.
We must hurry. They are in grave danger, I am sure of it.
You can't save them! You don't know what they've become.
But you haven't been up there. You haven't been under their influence.
They've been surrounded by blood mages whose wicked fingers snake into your mind and corrupt your thoughts.
You have to end it now, before it's too late.
Are you really saving anyone by taking this risk? To ensure this horror is ended, to guarantee that no abominations or blood mages live, you must kill everyone up there.
Thank you. I knew you would make a rational decision.
Rational? How is this rational? Do you understand the danger?
I know full well of the dangers of magic, but killing innocents because they might be Maleficarum is not justice. I know you are angry.
You know nothing! I am thinking about the future of the Circle, of Ferelden! I am just willing to see the painful truth, which you are content to ignore. Ah, but what can I do?
What he says makes sense. Do not discard it out of hand. These mages are out of control. Perhaps.
As you can see, I am in no position to directly influence your actions, though I would love to deal with the mages myself. Don't waste time on me. Deal with Uldred, if that is what you plan to do. Once he is dead, I will be freed. No one ever listens. Not until it's far too late. Maker turn his gaze on you. I hope your compassion hasn't doomed us all.
Remember you, Irving's star pupil. Uldred didn't think much of you then, and I certainly don't see your appeal now. I'm quite impressed you're still alive. Unfortunately, that must mean you killed my servants. Oh well, they are probably better off dying in the service of their betters than living with the terrible responsibility of independence. And freeing them in the process. A mage is but the larval form of something greater. Your chantry vilifies us, calls us abominations, when we have truly reached our full potential. Look at Chantry has them convinced. They deny themselves the pleasure of becoming something glorious.
You're mad. There's nothing glorious about what you've become, Uldred.
Uldred? He is gone. I am Uldred, and yet not Uldred. I am more than he was. I could give you this gift, Wynn. You and all the mages. It would be so much easier if you just accepted it. But some people can be so stubborn. Resistance! Everywhere I go, resistance! How very inconsiderate! Wait, what do we have here? Why, it's the first enchanter. Come, say hello to your old apprentice, Irving. Don't mind the blood. He's had a hard day.
What have you done to him?
Stop him. He is building an army. He will destroy the Templars. And
you're a sly little fox, Irving. Telling on me like that. And here I thought he was starting to turn.
Never!
That's enough out of you, Irving. He'll serve me eventually. As will you. Killing you would be a waste. Your raw potential, with the strength of a demon behind it, would be unstoppable. I can do that. I can give you power and a new life. I don't think your opinion matters. That is what I've decided, and that is what will be done. Fight. If you must, it will just make my victory all the sweeter.
Don't forget the litany. It will thwart Uldred's attempts to control the mages and win this fight for us. Irving, are you all right?
I've been better. But I am thankful to be alive. I suppose that is your doing, isn't it, Wynne?
I wasn't alone. I had help.
I was surprised to see you standing there. But I am glad you have returned. The Circle owes both of you a debt we will never be able to repay. Come. The Templars await. We shall let them know that the tower is once again ours. I'll need you to guide me down the stairs. Curse whoever insisted the Circle be housed in a tower.